And here is your moderator, Brian.
Ah, very good. All right. We are getting close. We've got two sessions left. We're going to do a kind of what's next. We're going to talk about some sort of advanced topics. I feel like sort of all day has been advanced topics, but we're going to talk about some things that would sort of be classified as advanced topics. We're going to do a panel on that. We're going to do a real quick kind of what's coming next with OpenShift, and then we're going to do some sort of ask me anything with the OpenShift product management team. So thank you all for still being here and sticking around and so much attention. So great panel. We've got four different companies that are going to talk about four different kind of topics in this space. So Michael Haas from Vorworks is going to talk to us about IoT. Alessandro Concani from Intesa is going to talk to us about machine learning. Ken Chenis from ACI Worldwide is going to talk to us about real-time analytics, real-time analysis. And then Sphere Lenbrock is going to talk to us about going from Windows to Linux, about building brand new stacks, and about trying to do all this sort of with your hair on fire and training and learning to it at the same time. So Michael, I'm going to let you go ahead and start off. You can come on up here and present right off of this, and then we'll hold on and do a little bit of question and answer at the end.
Yeah, hello everybody. It's a great pleasure to be here. It's the first time for Vorwerk to present here at the OpenShift Commons. And that's because we just signed the contracts with Red Hat by the end of last year. I have to step forward here myself. Yes, the topic of my speech is actually from carpet manufacturer to a digital service provider for the home. And that's because Vorwerk, some of you from the European continent may know that we are traditionally a carpet manufacturer. We are founded in 1883, so quite old business. It's a family business still since then. And that's something very special in that area. We are still a family business. We were traditionally a pioneer for all things, and the carpets itself were very, we were a pioneer on that topic because at that time that was a complete different business, and that's still true for the present. Constantly reinventing everything, and after the carpets we invented vacuum cleaners. We're still doing with vacuum cleaners, and we were worldwide acting, and the moment we are around 650,000 people working for Vorwerk. That's quite impressive. Of course, I don't know anything, not all of them, but okay.
Most of them.
Most of them. Most of them, of course. most of our important, the most important thing of us, and that's also the topic of IoT, Brian said, is the Thermomix. Thermomix is, as you can read here, it's not a machine, not only a machine. Our intention is it's the heart of the kitchen. And the heart of the kitchen means you can do a lot of things with that. I don't want to sell that today to you, but of course you can buy that if you like. The important thing for us is not to let the people cook with them or whatever. You can read that, what you can do with that part. For us, it was very important to have a connection to the Wi-Fi, to have services around that. And these services around that is built up a complete ecosystem for us. You can see here a lot of services. They are not only digital, but also cooking classes, so you have your advisor that he can help you and is cooking with you, some cooking classes and whatever. You have a community. Of course, we do firmware updates. We synchronize recipes onto the machines, and that's the big IoT part we have. You can imagine that we have a lot of customers here. They are doing, at the moment, there are around 1.5 million devices in that topic. So we are having an ecosystem, a digital ecosystem with synchronizing 1.5 million devices. That's sometimes you can imagine that most of the people working, cooking at midday or in the evening, and of course at Christmas, And then there's the most business and where we have to scale up and scale down our platforms. And that's, we started it in, with the services. You can see here in 2014. At that point in time, OpenShift was not that in that place, so we could not use that. But by over the last years, we learned that we have to change something if we want to have that in future also available for the customers and present the services. And last year, I got the opportunity to be the executive for that project. It's called OpenShift Introduction. And with that project, we try to migrate all our services into our OpenShift platform. There are some challenges we are currently facing, especially for the IoT, because it's our own IoT service. And that's not that easy to bring that to a real container platform like OpenShift. Yeah, that's it for the moment, and are you?